E-commerce spending has almost tripled over the past decade, as shoppers go online to buy things instead of into traditional brick-and-mortar stores. This consumer pattern could have an effect on price inflation and how we measure it. When there's inflation, prices go up. But how much they go up over time may depend on where you shop, whether you're filling your cart on a website or in an actual store. According to Chicago Booth's Austan Goolsbee and Stanford's Peter Klenow, price inflation is lower online than it is at traditional stores, and including new and exiting goods in the calculation further widens the gap. To track inflation, economists have traditionally relied on the Consumer Price Index, or CPI, that measures the price a city dweller would usually pay for a basket of consumer goods and services, typically in a traditional setting as opposed to online. Along with Adobe Analytics, Goolsbee and Klenow helped create a more complete method of tracking inflation online. They devised a Digital Price Index, or DPI, which gathers monthly data about millions of online transactions from 80% of Fortune 500 retailers. The Digital Price Index reveals that from 2014 to 2017, e-commerce inflation was 1% lower per year than what was observed in the Consumer Price Index. And that gap widened to about 3 percentage points when the researchers took into account all the products that get introduced or pulled from market in any given year. And if we keep going through the years, that 3% difference could impact the future of the way shoppers fill their baskets. If online shopping continues to grow, it could influence overall inflation levels in the economy. This could potentially be a major concern to central bankers' inflation targets and to the standard way we measure price inflation,